Hi to the readers of Onmanorama. This is Sangeeth Sivan here. There are a lot of horror elements in the film. But then, it was not a film meant to be horror. You say, okay, we are setting out to do a horror film. That wasn't the idea. So, the idea was to have a story. We had a story where the horror element was an integral part of the story. But the story is about a mother-daughter, it's about friends, so there will be a little bit of humor. So how do we say it? It's a wholesome film actually, with a good dose of horror. We were doing a Hindi film with a producer from Bombay. So the dates got a little delayed of the actor. So once that happens in Bollywood, it is like a year gone. You know, when you say delay. So we had nothing yet to do. So we were just developing a story, me and a friend, Rohan, who was the writer of the Hindi film. So we were developing that for a Hindi film, basically. When I heard the story, I could see this whole film in Malayalam, in a place called Haripad, where I was born and brought up. So I have a lot of connections with that place. And everything in the story, I thought, could be placed in Haripad. I understood the temple, I understood the house. I also knew which house I should go. There's a lot of this mango, the carver. Everything was very crystal clear. And I said, my God, this can be actually translated into a Malayalam thing. So I told Rohan and the producer, look here, let's not do this in Hindi. What if we do it in Malayalam? Now, they have no idea of Malayalam. So, they trusted me. They said, sir, if the budgets can be, brought under control, then they wouldn't mind trying a regional film. So, once that was said, then the problem was two. One is that, we had a limited budget. And two, I needed to find someone who could devote full time to this project. So, Kuku is basically my first cousin. So he also grew up in Haripad. He also knows the family. So we used to always be together from April 1st to 14th of every year. We would be in Haripad because that coincided with the festival. So these things that I have seen, he's also seen. So I asked him, would you be interested? Are you free? Then he said, yes. Then I said, okay, this is a small gist of a story that I have. Does it appeal to you? So it appealed to him, then he said, fine, great, then we got in Malayalam writers. And I've never been far away from Malayalam. I always follow Malayalam films. And now you have, simultaneous releases in Bombay. So all the major films I always see, and I always loved Malayalam. See, it's not a question of, it's just that the Hindi gives you a little more budgets to explore larger form, a larger audience, that is all. If at all I have to make a film which requires some amount of thinking, something very different, and then Malayalam is the place to be. And I really love the kind of new age cinema that's happening, the kind of young technicians that are, available in Kerala, you will not have anywhere. So basically, I did a small film as an actor recently for a friend called Kotem. So that is where I met up with seven young, 25 max I thought. They used to be lightmen, they used to be pulling the generator, they used to do lighting, they used to do camera. Everything is done by seven young boys, and they were brilliant at their job. So that is when I said, oh, this is the kind of team you need to work with, because you also learn such a lot from them in terms of technology, in terms of the, after some time, when you get a little success, you become complacent, okay, life is like, but then you see the energy of these people, then it rubs onto you, and then you badly want to go back into doing something with them. So that was one of the main reasons why I really wanted to come back. See, basically, I don't do much here. Compared to other people, I'm a very chilled out guy. See, the thing is, films, yeah, I mean, I don't know anything other than films. And then there's a passion of mine, which is still photography. So I'm not into this race where, you know, I have to finish one film and immediately do the next one. I've never been like that. What I usually do is I finish one film and then I go on my travels with my camera. And then I go into that space. And when and where I get an idea, then I sit down. So it doesn't matter to me whether, you know, I do a film, two films in a year. Maybe I do one film in 3 years. It doesn't matter because I keep myself occupied in other things. And I'm very rich in the sense I'm very rich because my needs are very poor, very little. So that way I'm rich. So I don't need much to, you know, how much money do you need at the end of the day to live? So I'm quite happy, contented. So I like to do other things. That's a no-brainer actually, because Hindi gives you a wider audience, it gives you more money, but you don't get to explore greater subjects. I mean, if you have to do something which is meaningful, see, let's put it this way: meaningful, different kind of films. You like to do it here. Regular mass, you know, mass entertainment. Because that, see, there the question is, see, I'll. Very simple it is. I mean, if you make a good film in Malayalam, and the film may not give you a box office success, but it's a good film, you will always get your second film in Malayalam. Because there are people who will appreciate the effort, who will appreciate your talent and give you a film just because they know you are talented. So all that matters is to make a good film. So one big thing is out of your head. You only concentrate on making a good film. Whether it runs or not, it doesn't matter really. It has to, but at least if I can showcase my talent, then you know you will get a film. In Hindi, you are only as good as the last film. As in, how much money can you make for the producer? So the more you can make, the more acceptable you are. So then you will only go for those mass-oriented films which will make money. Because if it doesn't make money, no one will call you. Your phone will be silent. The audiences are easier there. That being said, it's tougher to please the audience in Kerala. Because there, if I say it's a comedy film, all you do is make them laugh. It can be, it need not have logics, but make them laugh. But here, though, even that's not possible. No, even in the humor, there should be a certain logics in place. Otherwise, they'll say, what is this? You know, so I guess it's a difference in, see, it's like this, every audience gets the film they deserve. Yeah, so basically they get their film, because for them, films are entertainment. Here, films are also food for thought, it needs to stimulate their thinking, so naturally it is different. So that's why you get a different sect of films here, and not that there. But it's all changing, but. Ah, that's a good question. He is doing one big film with some Mahesh Babu or whatever. And you never know when he's wanted. And, you know, and another major thing is that, you know, he's my brother, but that's fine. But, you know, you need to have something in your film to challenge him. Because, you know, it should be something that demands Santosh, a caliber cinematographer like him to do the job. So here we are talking about budgets. Here we are talking about a small film. So then, just being a brother is not reason enough to go and ask him, no? So, it's just that. We don't normally, of course, he knows I'm doing this, he knows the story, all that is fine. But, see, when you say I'm doing a small film, it's a small film. It's a small film within those parameters. No, first of all, this has got a lot to do with certain myths and beliefs that exist in that part of the world. I mean, so there's a whole lot of instances where there's this idol worship of snakes. That's a huge part of the film, okay? And the cow and all that, Manasala temple and all that is a part of the folklore of Haripad. Actually, I've grown listening to those from my grandmother. And there are certain pujas that we had to conduct in the film. So, and that was done in their compound only. So, you know, so basically we had to be, we took all the precautions. We are vegetarians that day. No one would eat, no one in the unit would eat meat. Because, you see, it's not about, it's about respecting that custom. So we didn't want to, you know, but then again it was difficult though, because we are dealing with a crew of 70 people. You don't know what they ate. But we made sure that we used to give them advance notice saying that, look here, today we are shooting at the Illam. Please refrain from thing. And then you have to respect that land. That Caesar's is all sacred. About that, I remember we were doing the climax, and there was a particular sequence where something had to appear. Whenever we would get ready for the shot, and it was the hottest days that we have shot. It was so hot. Haripad was like blistering me. I mean, we were having tough conditions to work on. The moment we used to set up the shot, the first day, it started blowing heavy wind. There used to be, you know, leaves falling. And we had just two big lights, you know, big ones. So, since we didn't have a rostrum, this used to be tied to the tallest tree. So, my lightman used to go up and tie it to the tree. But because of the winds, we could see it from here, you could see the tree going like that, you know, with the light. So, we like saying, oh my God, light will go. All that scare. And then it rained. And there was a whole lot of, a big column being, you know, put, and it's all freshly put by all these major people who come and do this. It's costly affair, and if the rainwater falls, you're finished. So at that point of time, we never even knew there would be rains. You know, there was, well, we had never prepared. But then we had to go somehow. It got damaged a little, but we could rescue that thing. So then first day it's okay. We left it at that. Second day again we shot everything else. When it came to that particular seat, again it rained. So there was, you know, we were much better prepared. We could easily control it. Then people started talking. You know, that's how we are. You know, suddenly, oh, see, whenever this happens, so now we are all, see, even if you don't believe in these things, when such instances happen, then you start doubting whether, okay, is it all right? Is it something that we have to do? So, in fact, I went to Varnashal and asked them also. So they said, no, nothing like that. If you're like this, is fine. There's a yearly puja that we do, that's enough. You don't have to do anything. But then, you see, with us, no, it's always because, it's not about superstition. See, we have been brought up with a certain belief. And when something like this happens, then you think the worst, no? Acting, no. Actually, after that one film, I have a newfound respect for actors, in the sense, you know, when we are directing, you know, we'll say, okay, one more, without thinking too much. But once you did one film in front of the camera, you know how difficult it is to get back and then do it a second time. So, nowadays, I'm a little more, you know, considerate of actors. I think the most enjoyable job definitely would be directing. Because, you know, that is the one that you enjoy the most. So, these are all instances where I come, I see the industry, I see how what the interest of the people are. I generally interact a lot with these young people to get their feedbacks on a lot of things. So, I guess it also helps me grow as a person, as a creative person. Forever, you need to be thinking. You know, because, you see, the film industry as we work, it's not there anymore. It's totally different. Oh, change. See, when we used to be there, we had to be in films. To be in films. You know, like to be a director, you need to go through an assistant director or have a filmic connection to come to film. And those equipments were, you know, much more expensive, very limited. Only a few people could have. Today, everyone here is a filmmaker, especially in Kerala. So, you have a DSLR or even an iPhone, you become. See, at least I can translate my thoughts or my ideas into a small film and then go to the producer and say, this is the kind of film I've done. It's so much more easier to to impress upon a producer to put in some money for the talent. That time we could never do all this. No, I mean, we see, when technology gets into everyone's hands and it's so cheap, then obviously the people who come into the industry are not necessarily people who are who have always been into films. No. Today you can have an engineer turn up one day and say, let me do a film. You know, and it's good because it's fantastic, because the kind of ideas they bring in is not what I'm going to bring in. No. See, what happens when I'm following, suppose if I were to be an assistant to any director, then what happens? My thinking mostly will become like him. My behavior towards other people will become like him. So basically, I become a smaller replica of the other guy. Now, if I'm coming from absolutely no filmy background, I have no one. I just come out and it's just my ideas. And they're not going to be conditioned by something which I've seen or observed. It's something new, absolutely. Then that gives rise to a different kind of films. Like you say, a Mahesh and the Pradigara, for example. Where if that time, if I used to go and tell a story of so much, such a thin line, they would say, what is this? Where is the story? They will ask, no. But today, that is not the point. The point is, the 2.5 hours I spent, I watched it 4 times. It's just that I found it entertaining. I came across people whom I've never seen. I would love to see those characters again. Their, you know, their queen, their quirkiness, all these impress upon me. And I've never been to Idiki. Maybe that's also another point. But it keeps you engrossed. So as long as a film gets you engrossed, I think you have succeeded. So it's not necessary that you should have a huge story. And that time, I don't think anyone had any idea of technical knowledge, you know. Today, anyone in the theatre will say, no, 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 the colour temperature is wrong, this is wrong. So, because technology is available to anyone. So, when everyone is aware of technology, two things happen. One is that everyone becomes a judge and everyone thinks he's the best, which is fine, which is how it is. But yeah, there's a lot of differences. And I think Kerala audiences are much more critical. They were always critical before. But now, though, more so. Upcoming, honestly, I need to see how this film is accepted. See, I am not looking at this film as a, you know, as a big blockbuster or anything. If it just gets me my investment, and then, you know, I'll be very happy, because, you know, I've really enjoyed the process. I've come back to Malayalam. I've made new friends. I've made new this thing. So all that will put me on the plus side. And then also, it has helped me realize where, you know, the film is, Malayalam films are, their kind of level, their kind of standard. So it will help in me making a decision of my next film, which is definitely on next year maybe. But yeah. I'm sure that this whole experience, you know, will make me better prepared for a film to be directed.